The black community began to organize and increase its pressure on city officials to produce jobs. Ironically, one of the most significant figures in the black community during this period was not black, but a white priest known by the community simply as Father Groppi.
When someone black came to me and said, "Look, Father, they won't rent to me beyond 27th Street at that time. What did you want me to do as a white priest in Henry City Parish?" "Well, look, I'm white. You go see this black minister over there, or you go see the NAACP." Now, that was my fight. Those prisoners were my family. They were committed to my care. It was my responsibility to be out there and to be in the middle of that fight. I have never advocated an escapist theology where people get their wounds dressed or whatever else you want to call it by telling them, "Don't worry about it, Sam. You're going to have life hereafter." I never advocated that. Someone was doing you an injustice and you were part of my parish, that made it my fight.
Now, ain't it good to know that you've got a friend when people can be so cold? They'll hurt you.
Yes,
and deserve
you. Do you want a black police chief?
And take your soul if you let them.
Quite the thought.
Mayor, Mike.
Oh, but don't you let them.
Apparently you're not getting the answers here, Mayor.
Father Groppi was an exciting, he is an exciting and complex, most dedicated, most committed priest, who was controversial because he was a priest, but who is a sensitive, dear, dear person. Not any of the things that a lot of people think, look at him as, you know, very volatile and very abrasive and very aggressive. He is really a very sensitive man and a really a quiet person, and not an easy person to know, and a dear person. He loved being a part of that social change.
And when I look back on it, I think that Gropp was probably one of the most misunderstood people in this whole city. He was not the man who kindled the fire. He was the one who kept the lid on it. That's the reason Milwaukee didn't burn. He provided young minority people with an opportunity in a constructive manner to vent those frustrations and to say to the system the kinds of things that they wanted to say in a constructive manner. Had he not been there, Milwaukee would have probably burned.
We are picketing Father Groppi today because we want to awaken people of the state to a fact of what's going on here. The fact is simply this, that these people are agitating, they are trying to stir up trouble, and we are trying to suppress that trouble.
They don't bother us. They're like the Ku Klux Klan and the White Citizens Councils. We know exactly who they are and what they are. They are enemies. They believe in race superiority.
We don't want another Watts riot or any other kind of black riot in Wisconsin.
They don't bother us as much as the white moderates who say that they are our friends and then constantly pour cold water on our actions.